Made in Hollywood.
In the coming-of-age story, The Only Living Boy in New York, a recent graduate struggling to find his voice finds two unexpected mentors in Jeff Bridges and Kate Beckinsale.
Hey, I'm Kiersey Clemons. You're watching Made in Hollywood, and here's a clip from my movie, The Only Living Boy in New York.
I just moved into 2B.
Huh. Thomas Webb.
Why so troubled, Thomas?
I'm having a bad day.
What's her name?
I loved this script. I just was hanging on every word. I just found it so yummy. What was the yes for you about this project?
Well, Alan Lowe wrote a wonderful script, and I understand it was his first movie that he got made. It was very exciting. And then after meeting with the director, Mark Webb, I really, you know, got on well with him, and heard about the cast that he was thinking about, and finding Callum Turner, that he would be involved, and I saw some footage of his that really excited me, and so it was just it was a good project.
One of the things I found really interesting about the movie is that you can make choices you're not necessarily proud of and still be a good person, essentially. You know, and I thought that was a really interesting thing.
Well, I'm crazy about you.
I'm crazy about you, but
don't say as friends.
Why? Why is that so bad?
I loved what you and Callum Turner, who plays Thomas in the movie, what you guys did, the rapport. What did you do to create that type of chemistry, that rapport, that type of simpleness? Did you have rehearsal?
We kind of just jumped into it, like on a personal level, just hanging out with each other. I think there are just some people where you like can banter and it's easy to vibe, and me and Callum, for sure, we're able to just like hang and talk and be on the same page, and that's really, it's special, it's nice.
Let life take over, find a window and pounce.
What's my father doing here?
Who's he with?
I don't know.
I was constantly asking myself questions about her, like who is she, what makes her tick, and I really loved like how you brought her to life.
Oh, thank you. It was really important for me that she wasn't just this kind of sex mistress. Like, both of these guys are good people, you know, and so the person they're going to be attracted to is also going to be a decent human being.
You're being really obvious.
You're an innocent, Thomas, and you've got no idea how the world works.
I know some things.
Like what?
Well, some people see this as a love story. Some people see this as a coming-of-age story. Mm-hmm. What story do you see this as?
Well, both of those, certainly. And also, a mystery.
I think from all the characters and the perspectives that everyone is coming from, I think everyone's gonna watch it and walk away feeling different.
I felt it's such a human story. It's flawed human beings kind of blindly going through their lives, trying to do their best. I think being a human being is really hard sometimes.
Life's random as it is deliberate, funny as it is tragic. Yours is no exception.